Good morning students. Today in this very video lesson we shall be learning on body movement. So you have turned to page number 78, which is chapter number 9. Okay, body movement. So in this very lesson we will be talking about movements of our body. So see, look at various objects around you. You will notice that some of them move from one place to another, while in others some part of the objects move. See, our move, what is movement? See, I'm moving, right? I'm moving from left side to right side. See, this is a body movement, okay? So there is different kind of movements, right? See, like I move of a car, and like I move of a butterfly, right? While a butterfly moves, it only moves its wings, right, at first. But when a vehicle moves, it moves its whole body together, right? So these are the movements, okay? So here we will talk about some of the movements. So movement occur when a part or whole of the living things change position from one place to another. Movement is a significant feature of the living things, okay? See, and while writing in your notebook also, you move your hand, you move your fingers, right? And even you move your eyes, you blink your eyes, it is also a movement, okay? So movement means while you write, you move your hands, you move your fingers. While I'm talking, I'm moving my lips, right? These are the movements, okay? And you also move from one place to another. Example, you get up and go to school, right? You get up in the morning, you dress up, you go to school, right? From getting up from your bed and reaching till your school, it's all movement, okay? If you do not move, then you will not reach to school. You are moving, only then you are reaching to school, okay? These are our movements. So now we have different kind of movements, okay? Different kind of movements, let me explain you. Firstly, we have locomotion. What do we have? We have locomotions, okay? The locomotion is a movement in which an organism moves as a whole from one place to another. A locomotion is a characteristic of animals and humans. So, locomovement is also a movement, okay? So, it means you can take example of a human or any other living organism. When we move our whole body, right? When we walk from here to that point, see, I'm going. My whole body is moving from one corner to another corner, right? So this is locomotion, okay? Even animals, they are, while they move their whole body, right? Working from one point to another point. They carry their whole body to reach that another point, right? So that is locomotion, okay? L-O-C-O-M-O-T-I-O-N. That is locomotion, okay? Moving the whole body, okay? And need for locomotion. Why do we need locomotion? Okay, importance of locomotion. You must have seen that animals move from one place to another, but why do they need locomotion? Locomotion helps animals in many ways. Okay, these are it enables them to move from one place to another place in search of food, right? And it enables them to move from unfavorable environment to favorable environment. It helps them to get away from enemies and danger. Please look at your book, page number 78, Need for Locomotion. Okay. Firstly, why do animals need locomotion? Why is it important for animals, right? So it is important for animals because while they are going for search of food, right, they move their whole body with them, not only their mouth. We eat anything, food, anything with our mouth, right? So animals, while they go in search of food, they move their whole body. That's why they need locomotion. If they do not have a locomotion, then they cannot go they cannot go in search of food, right? And secondly, why do they need locomotion? They need locomotion because they can move from one place to another place. For example, a particular animal cannot live in a hot place, okay? So he have to, or that very animal have to go to a cool place, which is a cooler place, right? tired, he need a locomotion. He cannot live in a hot weather, so he has to go to cool weather, right? So he need locomotion to move from one point to another point. Okay, and it helps them to get away from enemies and danger. See, now animals, they used to eat each other, right? So while the enemies come and attack them, they cannot stay in one place, right? If they stay in one place, then they will die, right? So here they need locomotions. They will run, right? Run from one place to another to save his life. So running to save his life is locomotion, because his whole body is moving together, right? So that is locomotion, and that is why animals need locomotion. Okay, and modes of locomotion. Now we'll talk about the modes of locomotion. See how they move. Okay, modes of locomotion, how they move. Okay, we'll talk different kind of modes. Various organisms use different methods of locomotion. The mode of locomotion used by animals depends on the size of the animals and the medium in which it moves. See, now animals move in different types, right? It depends on their size, okay? It depends on their size, and it depends also in the medium of its move. Some animals move in water, they walk in water. Some in just like bird, they fly on air, right? And some on land, like we have lion, tigers, they walk only on land, right? So that is the medium, okay, where they used to work. And the different modes of locomotion are different types, okay? Now some walk, right? Some run, some fly, some jump, some crawl. Okay, these are the modes, okay? Climbing, swimming, these are different kind of modes. A bird cannot swim, right? But some bird can swim till but an animal cannot fly, right? And fish cannot fly. So these are the different types of modes, okay, that animal used to move their body. Okay, now movement of earthworm. We will talk about the movement of earthworm. Okay, how an earthworm move. So you turn to page number 79. Movement of earthworm. So the body of an earthworm doesn't contain any bone. Yes, earthworm, you know what is earthworm, right? In the body of earthworm there is no bones, right? But how do they move without the help of a bones, right? Here we are confused, but see, how do they move? They move with the help of the muscles, okay? In the body of earthworm there is no bones, but still then there is a strong muscle, okay, which help them to move their body. It is like a rubber, okay, nylon or rubber. They move with the help of their muscle. Firstly, it will contract, right? It will contract. It will contract its muscle. It will become small in size, and then they will expand. That means they will become bigger in size. That's how they move. You know, you might have seen how earthworm move, right? They move from one place to another place without the bones, but only with the help of a muscle. Okay, firstly they will contract its muscle, and then they will expand it. Okay, that's how they are going from one place to another place. And it has a tiny bristles called stadia. Look at your textbook. Okay, it has a tiny bristle called stadia on its body, which helps them the earthworm to attach itself to the surface. Okay, now we'll talk about the movement of